It's like this energy. You have to really want to help people. It's not like you can just create a piece of content with valuable information and then have this, oh, I hope they buy from me, I hope they buy from me, energy behind it. Good morning, everyone. This is Marlene Christensen from Denmark. I'm just out taking a morning walk, and because I feel that when my body is moving, the energy is moving, and I get more creative, and also I get a little bit of exercise. So I have taken you along with me today because I wanted to talk a little bit about trust. As online marketers, marketers in general, we know that trust is everything. If you want to sell something, people don't buy what they don't trust. And I've been hearing this trust equation for ages, like, you know, you probably have heard it. It's the know, like, and trust factor or equation. And it has to do with people who don't know you start by seeing you for the first time, so they know who you are. Then they see you more than once, then they start to like what they see, hopefully. And in the end, when they have seen you enough times, they start to trust you. But this is this equation, it's just something you can put down on paper. How does it really work in real life? And first off, of course, people have to see you and see your message. So you can do that by writing blogs and doing videos, any form of content. And then they have to see you more than once. And you do that, it's not as easy as it used to be. Back 10 years ago when I started in online marketing, there was not a lot of people around doing all of this stuff. And you only had so many people to come to for advice and see the content. But these days, you know, everybody has their own YouTube channel and everybody is talking on Twitter and everybody is on Facebook. And there's so much noise out there. So today, if you want people to see you more than once, you can make them subscribe to your blog or your YouTube channel, of course, by in your videos asking them to do so. But also you can use the software technology. You can pixel them, so to speak. There's a little bit of software that can track people or put a little tag on them. And then you with this software, build a database actually of people who have seen you, and you can make sure they see the next content you put out. You can push that to everybody you have a tag on. And there's so many YouTube videos and also blog posts about how to do this. So you can search for Google Tag Manager or Facebook Pixel and you will learn more about it. Maybe I'll even do a tech video on this sometime. But the last thing is they need to trust you also before they buy from you. And that's the trust factor that is, it's just like been advertised for. If they see you enough times, they will trust you. And there's of course some truth to that, because they would not want to see you more than once if they did not like what you put out and trust a little bit what you say. But of course, it's more, for me, it's more like, how do you make friends, right? How do you make friends? It should not be some kind of scientific equation. You meet friends by helping them. You make friends by sharing what you know. You make friends by caring. That's the trust, you know. It's no different than making friends. I know that talking to a camera can seem a little artificial, So what I do, I actually picture people I want to help, picture people I know, and I would love to provide value for. I picture them in my head before making a video, and I'm talking to them. And I know if I'm helping those people with my content, I probably will help other people as well. So you should not treat this no like and trust equation like something you put down on paper and something you have to become good at. You should just treat it as making friends in a virtual community. So I hope this video has this piece of content has gotten you a little closer to know, like, and trust me. and also there's this part about you come to a sleazy salesperson, for instance, like a car, that's the stereotype, that the sleazy car salesperson. You might come there a few times and he's also providing value about the cars, but there's something off. You just don't trust that person. So being in the right mind of being of service, and you should, it's like this energy, you have to really want to help people. It's not like you can just create a piece of content with valuable information and then have this, oh, I hope they buy from me, energy behind it. You have to really want to make friends. If it's all just an act to make people buy from you, they will know, they can feel it, and they will not trust you, no matter how valuable your content is. They might like, okay, thank you for that content, and then move on, right? You have to really be of service in that kind of, coming from that kind of energy. That's important too. So I hope this maybe demystifies a little bit what this know, like, and trust thing is. It's no different than in real life. So I wish you a very good day. I hope you got some value, and I'll see you in another episode. Bye. Thank you for listening or watching this content. I hope it has brought you some value. I hope it's been inspiring or motivating or given you some kind of new idea to maybe get out of a rut or maybe really go and crush it. Listen, I'm just an ex-computer programmer who got into a car crash back in 2001, and it took me several years to get out of that. And during that time, I studied everything there was to study about spirituality and personal growth. And finally, I found my way to finding my passion, and that is online marketing and online business building. That's a platform that I really love to help inspire people to create the life and the freedom that they want in their life and build a legacy and impact the world for the better. Now, if you want to follow me on this journey, you can find me on social media or go to my blog, askmarilena.com. That's askmarilena.com. And I hope to see you in another episode. Bye for now.